Hi everyone. Is it advisable to offer tea or coffee to the patients who are suffering with asthma? Or what actually you mean by Monte Leucast and how these drugs are going to be work? So to know about these questions, so today we are going to discuss the topic anti-asthmatic agents. Asthma is a chronic inflammatory disorders of the airways. So here normally the lung consisting of the trachea, bronchi. So here the inflammation is caused due to hypersensitivity reactions. So maybe a small dust particles or a pollen grain can cause the irritation at that particular site, and our body reacts vigorously to this particular stimuli, and it start responding and secreting various harmful chemicals like histamines, leukotrienes and cytokines. So makes the situation worse, and that particular area is going to be filled with all the edema. So resulting of that, the individual are able to breathe properly, and the worst thing is these are going to be happen at early mornings and late nights. So where the chance of help is less. So that is the reason why the deaths is around 5,000 deaths per annum because of this asthma. Various stimulants, various factors may be responsible for this. So maybe the smoking, the food we take, the area, the environment we live, that may cause the stimulation of our hypersensitivity reaction of and cause this asthma. Here the asthma, it is, as we said, this is a chronic inflammatory disorder at the bronchi. So first let us see like what is there in the bronchi and how different agents are responsible for the constriction of this bronchi. So resulting of that, the patient is unable to breathe, right? So here, so this is the basic structure of the lung, where this is called as a trachea, and these tiny are said to be the bronchi. So if you take this transverse section of this bronchi, so we can see this is the area where air is going to be passed. Okay, this is epithelial cells, in which the specific cells are going to be present, called as goblet cells, and this is mucus layer. Mucus layer is consisting of a specified cells called as mast cells, in which the histamine is going to be present as a granule form. Apart from that, here there is a muscular smooth muscle ring is going to be there, which controls the contraction and relaxation of the bronchi. So again, upon which the submucous layer is going to be present. So here in this, the blood supply is going to be there. Eosinophils, mononuclear cells are going to be present in this. So this is the basic structure of this bronchi. So how this structure going to be helpful to understand the asthma? Okay, here we will see. Okay, here when because of the stimuli, if there excess of the mucus is secreted by these globular cells, more sputum is going to be generated. Okay, so here when it is do this, so here the available space is going to be lessened than compared to the normal. Then, so as you see this, in this mucus layer we have a specialized cells called as mast cells. Okay, so when there is any infection or when there is a damage, so normally the calcium is going to be entered to this mast cells and is going to be degranulate the histamine, and histamine is going to be released. As you know, this histamine is a potent vasoconstrictor, so obviously this is going to be constrict this vessel. So this is one of the factor for causing this asthma. And moreover, so we can see this, the mononuclear cells and eosinophils, whenever any inflammation is there, inflammation is try to penetrate towards this. Okay, to for the penetration of this, various chemokines, leukotrienes, cytokines are going to be response. Okay, once it reaches to this the site of infection or site of irritation, so normally these are going to be release leukotrienes, harmful chemicals which will try to kill the pathogen as well as the nearby cells. So here, because of this, the diameter of this mucus and submucous layer is going to be enlarged. So that is nothing but the swelling of this bronchi. So makes the available space very less for the air passage. So you can see this same here. So for example, this is the normal bronchi. So if because of this stimuli, so here there will be a shrinkage of this airway. So that makes the patient difficult in breathing. So that is the main problem with the asthma. Okay, apart from this, allergens, mold spores, dust. So here there will be physical agents also contribute. So if the individual is doing physical heavy work, okay, that may triggers the asthma. And cold air, weather conditions and the air quality, that normally triggers the asthma. Okay, normally we can diagnose by the spirometry. So if you see this the drugs which will treat the asthma, so here we should understand that there is no complete cure of this asthma. Only thing is we can make better we can decrease the symptoms and the quality of the patient's patient life can be increased, but we cannot completely cure the asthma. Okay, so here basically drugs can be categorized into short term relievers and long term controllers. Okay, short term relievers, example beta adrenergic agonist. Okay, as you know, this beta receptors are going to be present on the heart and the lung. If you see this, beta 1 is predominant in heart, beta 2 is predominant in lungs. See here, beta adrenergic agonist can be again further categorized as acting on both beta 1 and beta 2. So example epinephrine, ephedrine. So beta 2 selective agonist, I mean to say, so since beta 2 receptors are predominant in lungs, so we'll see this beta 2 selective. So it is, example is albuterol and terbutaline. So these are the agents which will bind to this receptor and cause the relaxation of this particular muscle. So relaxing, so that causes the easy passage of this. Next category of the drugs, methyl xanthan. As our question, so here this is good to offer the tea or coffee to the patient who are suffering with the asthma, because so this coffee or tea has the caffeine, theophylline and theobromine. So though it is a very less content is present in the tea and coffee, normal taking this coffee and tea, but some extent these are going to be helpful. Okay, so this is always helpful for the patients in relaxing of these muscles. Next, anti-muscarinic agents. As we discussed that here there is a smooth muscle which consisting of the muscarinic receptors. Upon raising of the acetylcholine on this muscarinic receptor, obviously these smooth muscle is going to be get contracted. So here what we are doing is we are blocking the muscarinic agents. So here example is ipratropium. Okay, so these are the drugs useful for the short term use. Normally we'll take, so normally we'll see that those individuals who are suffering with the asthma, they will take some device and they will take some powder like thing. Okay, so that is nothing but the beta 2 selective agonist, albuterol and terbutaline. So these are going to be directly enter into the lung and work on the beta 2 receptors, and is drastically is going to be decrease the contraction. So within a minutes the patient is going to be get normal. So that is the basic logic in this. Next, for the long term, so long term is this long term controllers is corticosteroids, example prednisolone, hydrocortisone and beclomethasone. So these are the steroidal drugs. So basically what it will do is, so when there is an infection, so normally these eosinophils and mononuclear cells are try to penetrate to this and is going to be released various cytokines, leukotrienes and various other chemicals which will initiate the inflammation at that particular area. So here these steroids are inhibit the penetration of these mononuclear cells or eosinophils, thereby decrease the inflammation. Decreased inflammation may helpful for the early recovery of the patient. So whereby the swelling is going to be get reduced and the patient is going to be feel better. So that is the basic logic of these corticosteroids. Next, leukotrienes pathway antagonist. So this is very important drugs: montelukast, cefalocast, and jutilin. So here normally these drugs, so here T cells are going to be secrete harmful chemicals, leukotrienes. Okay, so here this leukotrienes are going to be antagonized by using these drugs. In the sense, these are the immunomodulators. What is the immunity cells are doing? So they are blocking this immune cells reactivity. So thereby it's going to be decrease the inflammation. Okay, so that is how these are going to work. Example, montelukast. Then inhibition of the mast cells degranulation. Here we said that mast cells are going to be present, is going to be secrete the histamine. So here will inhibit the degranulation of this mast cells, resulting of that the histamine is not going to be released. So here the contraction can be controlled. In this way we can treat these patients. Example, chromolyl sodium and nidocromide. So here these are the drugs, and this is how these drugs are going to be utilized. So hope this video is useful. Thank you.